Surprising changes are a regular part of SpaceX's approach, and their latest decision has drawn attention. Now the focus is on Starship's lattice fins. SpaceX is testing a new design that has just 3 lattice fins instead of the usual 4. Why remove fins from such a critical system? Is it to save weight, simplify the design, or use new control software? Whatever the reason, this major change raises important questions about Starship's future development. Let's dive deeper into today's episode of NR Studio. We'll discuss how Starship continues to evolve as SpaceX works to create an efficient next-generation launch vehicle. Each new prototype features small but significant design changes, helping SpaceX move closer to its goal of making space travel more routine, cost-effective, and sustainable. One of the recent major changes involves the Super Heavy boosters. SpaceX has successfully landed these massive first stages on Mechazilla arms 3 times, but there are more improvements to come. In a recent discussion, Elon Musk revealed that a future version of the rocket booster will have only 3 lattice fins arranged in an asymmetrical pattern instead of the usual 4. The new booster will be about 72.3 meters tall and will be paired with the next generation Starship upper stage, bringing the total height to 124.4 meters. This can be seen as the second full version of the Starship system, with both stages significantly increased. There is even talk of a third version that could reach a height of 142 meters. Given the problems with the second version, some believe SpaceX may move to a third version. So why is SpaceX reducing the number of lattice fins and changing the traditional balance used on almost all reusable rockets, including the current Super Heavy? At first glance, this may seem like a bad idea, as lattice fins are essential for controlling the rocket during re-entry and landing. However, this change actually stems from a series of technical and operational improvements. From an engineering standpoint, having fewer lattice fins but positioning them differently could improve the rocket's flight capabilities. The new arrangement could improve the vehicle's ability to perform somersault maneuvers during descent. This flip positions the booster for its final landing. On its 9th flight, SpaceX successfully performed this flip, which aided the landing. With fewer fins, the weight shift and aerodynamics can make the flip easier. Once inverted, the new fin placement can create balance, reducing drag during re-entry. This can result in better control during descent and lower fuel usage to correct the landing path. This design change looks promising for future flights. SpaceX is trying a new way to land at a steeper angle. This could help them land more gently and improve their accuracy in pulling the rocket. With the new fins, they can maintain control even during a steep descent. Fewer fins create more space around the rocket. This could make it easier to line up and catch the rocket, which could mean less complex engines and faster recovery. There are also practical benefits. Each lattice fin on the Super Heavy booster weighs about 3 tons and is about the size of a door. Removing just one of them would lighten the rocket, which could result in better performance, less stress on the engines, and the ability to carry more payload while using fuel more efficiently. Cost is another big reason for redesigning the fins. Unlike the Falcon 9, which uses expensive titanium fins, the Super Heavy uses cheaper but stronger stainless steel fins. SpaceX spent about $10,000 for 3 tons of stainless steel, which is much cheaper than titanium. While cutting one fin may not seem like a huge money saver, when you consider the thousands on Starship, it adds up. Fewer fins also mean faster production, easier repairs, and fewer parts to inspect. This change reflects SpaceX's goal to simplify everything. They are working to make every part of Starship cheaper, faster, and more scalable. This will help them have more successful launches at a lower cost. The new 3-fin design will likely be first seen on Booster 18. It has been upgraded and resembles a test tank. The goal is to have it ready for flight later this year, if all goes according to plan. What do you think about removing the louver fins? It's not something you're used to seeing, but SpaceX's method of incremental improvements could make it a smart move. If you support this change, type yes in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe to stay up to date on SpaceX's journey to transform space travel. In addition to the louver fin adjustments, there will be another major upgrade to the next Super Heavy booster rocket. All of these changes are part of SpaceX's plan to make their rockets more reusable and efficient. In the new design, there will be fewer fins and their positions will also be different. The thruster's louver fins are now positioned lower. Previous flight data suggests that the current placement of the fins is too close to the hot exhaust from Starship's upper stage engine during the warm-up phase. This sometimes causes minor melting and wear on the fins. While this damage is not mission critical, it does mean additional time for inspection and repairs between flights. By lowering the louver fins, SpaceX hopes to protect them from overheating, which will reduce the need for repairs and help make the booster more reusable over time. Another major improvement to the next generation Super Heavy is the warm-up stage system. In SpaceX's latest presentation, Musk introduced a new warm-up stage ring, a key part of the Super Heavy booster. The upgrade marks a major step toward full reusability. Inspired by the Soviet N-1 rocket, the new warm-up stage ring is intended to be recovered and reused on each mission, rather than discarded. It is now longer and has larger exhaust vents to better handle the forces and heat generated during engine ignition and stage separation. This design helps protect sensitive areas like the louver fins and the booster's front dome from damage. The new ring features a simple zigzag support structure, which reduces the overall weight of the vehicle and makes it easier to manufacture. The change reflects a broader focus on simplicity across the Starship system, since simpler systems are easier to build, inspect, repair, and launch. This philosophy helps lower costs and speeds turnaround times, moving SpaceX closer to its goal of creating a fully reusable launch system. The hot staging ring is just one of several improvements coming to the Super Heavy booster. The biggest change is the new Raptor 3 engine. The Raptor 3 has a sleek black finish, but the real upgrade is inside. Many of the small parts that are usually mounted on the outside have been removed or integrated into the engine body, reducing points of failure and making it more robust in harsh conditions. The engine's cooling system has also been improved to better manage heat during operation. Most notably, the Raptor 3 no longer requires its own heat shield, simplifying production and reducing weight. Musk said the new engine appears more open, indicating SpaceX's growing confidence in its ability to survive tough launch conditions without additional protection. In addition to being more reliable and easier to manufacture, the Raptor 3 brings significant improvements overall. Performance improvements. The Super Heavy booster produces a whopping 280 tons of thrust at sea level and 306 tons in space. With its 33 engines, the total thrust at liftoff could reach more than 9,000 tons. This brings SpaceX closer to its goal of 10,000 tons of thrust, which would make Starship the most powerful launch system ever. To handle this extra power, the next Super Heavy booster will have larger fuel tanks. These larger tanks can hold more fuel, allowing for heavier payloads or longer missions. The combination of larger tanks and more powerful engines gives SpaceX more options for their missions. In addition to these major upgrades, there have been many improvements under the hood. Internal plumbing has been redesigned for better reliability, wiring has been simplified, and new materials have been used to handle cold conditions. Even the points for the robotic systems have been improved. All of these changes make the booster more durable and easier to maintain, helping SpaceX launch more often in the future. SpaceX's long-term plan is clear. Small steps like removing the lattice fins, redesigning the hot staging ring, upgrading the Raptor 3 engines, and increasing the size of the tank all work together. These changes lower costs, improve reliability, and help speed reusability. However, there are still challenges ahead. The Super Heavy booster has shown that it can land using the Mechazilla arm, but it still needs to prove that it can perform well in full flight. Consistency from flight to flight will be crucial as launch frequency increases. The Starship upper stage also needs to be improved. It has had issues this year, such as thermal protection issues and engine failures, and more recently, the loss of S-36. SpaceX needs to focus on fixing these issues, which include improving the thermal protection system, validating the in-orbit engine burn, strengthening the structure, and refining the recovery method. Testing will ramp up soon, starting with B18 in the first V3 prototypes. These tests will showcase key innovations like the new triple lattice fin design, the updated hot staging ring, and the powerful new Raptor engines. That's it for today's episode, and see you in the next one. Thank you for your support.